But they want me to pretty much tell you a little bit about myself. I'm a senior at Northside High School in Warren Robins, Georgia. Warren Robins is a military city. We are mostly known for our Air Force Base. Actually, the city itself was originally named Wilson. Warren Robins came, we're named after our Air Force Base, which is Robins Air Force Base. I've actually kind of been working on my research since, I guess you said, since I was 13, if it adds up. In Houston County, which is where I'm from, in seventh and eighth grade, students are required to do the regional science competition for the gifted program. I'm a member of the gifted program in my school, and we're required to do it on our seventh and eighth grade year. My seventh grade year, my first project was trying to find the best way to propagate lima beans using different types of water. Wasn't too spectacular. I didn't advance it well. And it comes up to the keynote speaker's point of having a good mentor. That year, I had a teacher that actually gave us a 30-page packet that told us all about science competitions. We never met. We never had help or anything about that. The next year, I went to a middle school in Warren Robins. I had a teacher by the name of Ms. McCall. She was such an inspiration to me. She actually worked with us. The other students didn't have that same appreciation because they weren't given a 30-page packet. They weren't forced to make up their own ideas and just do, come out of nothing. But for me, that was, I was so appreciative of that. And for that, I promised her that year that I would do it at least one more year, and that was my high school year. My ninth grade year, I did another homemade project. I did three books worth of log books my ninth grade year for my science teacher's project. And a scientist noticed my project at a science competition in Houston County. And he asked me to come check out his laboratory. I didn't think that much of it. But I found out later on that it actually comes down to opportunities. I had nothing else to do that summer, actually. I volunteered about 60 hours, and then the rest of my summer was pretty much blank. So I took the scientist up on his offer, and I actually went to a historically black college by the name of Fort Valley State University in Fort Valley, Georgia. And the week that I went to visit the campus, I happened to go the week of a teacher's workshop. And the teacher's workshop, they brought in many scientists from all across the country talking about their areas of biotechnology and what interests them the most. Because I was interested in plants, I asked them, could I work in plant biotechnology, and I ended up doing that at Fort Valley State. Ever since then, they've been training me for the past 3 years, and this year, if you're asking my project, the anti-cancer activity of Scutellarium, AKT, PKB signaling. I actually took the plants that I grew at Fort Valley State University and I tested them on brain cancer cell lines. And so I didn't do that project at Fort Valley State, I did that project at Carmano Cancer Institute. And that brings me to my next point, guys. It's all about taking opportunity. Coming to this competition for me is actually quite significant because this is my 30th science competition I've ever done. So for me, it's actually quite a big moment. And it's not just about science competitions, because a lot of people might think I don't have a life. I'm actually supposed to be at school right now. I'm the class president. We're working on our senior ball. I'm the president of Veggie Club. I don't know if you guys know what that is, but that's a kind of a volunteer organization. I'm also an area officer in Future Farmers of America. It's about being well-rounded, getting out there. And you might also think that I don't go to school a lot. I really don't. I usually miss 30 to 40 days a semester. But it's actually quite hard to keep up, but guys, it's well worth it. I have a 4.0 and a 97 point. I figured out a long time ago that it's all about taking every opportunity. That's why I came here. I believe I am a true opportunist. If everything you give at me, I'll take it. That's why, actually, to help my public speaking skills, I even joined a debate team, and I'm a debate captain as well. So it's about just taking one. It's about taking on every competition. Just coming here, I've actually learned a lot. For one, I've applied and actually got accepted to Duquesne University. Before I came here, I was saying Duquesne. Brought it up earlier that Charles Drew actually died in Macon, Georgia. $1,000 for me. And that's actually somewhat quite significant because, you know, he was in a car accident and they wouldn't treat him because he was an African American. So who would think that, you know, about 50 years later that someone from Warner Robins, Georgia would be coming to a competition named after him. So I thought for me that was quite interesting. But I want to thank you all for your hospitality. It's been great and good luck.